show. I have a pastor on my show, and he's running for councilman, first district. The T-shirt, you notice in the audience, everybody have on his logo. And this is what it looks like in the back. And this is the front, as you can see. But this is my guest, and he's running for the first district, the councilman. Mm-hmm. Please welcome Missy Tagaloa to the TW show. I'm so excited to have you on my show. A matter of fact, we neighbors. That's right. Mm. I happened to see him on my street, and you spotted me immediately.
Yeah, we did some work before when it was Charter Media.
That was 15 years ago.
I had a program there, Yo Tomanuia. I don't know if you remember.
No, I don't remember. Yeah. Yo Tomanuia. You know, I don't want to lie, but yeah. I could. So. I don't want to lie to a pastor. Amen. It was called what now?
Ia o Tomanuia.
All righty, yeah. And that meant what?
It's Jesus is saying, peace be with you, right, when he resurrected.
Oh, that is so nice. Yeah. So you remember me when you was doing, I'm gonna say it his way, peace be with you. Yeah. And you spotted me.
Yep, it's hard to forget you.
Is that a good thing?
It's a good thing, you're effervescent and
okay, my tissue fell, I can't pick it up because we don't have time. Okay, yeah. So. You're running for first district. Let me show you guys. This is it. And I did awesome pictures. Awesome pictures.
Thank you.
And he's running for first district. Long Beach City Council District is November 5th, correct?
That's the last day to vote.
That's
correct.
That's the last day to vote.
Yes.
Okay, now, I have questions for you, okay? First of all, you're a pastor.
Yes.
That's what you say. Where's your church located? What's the name of your church?
Second Samoan United Church of Christ.
Second Samoan. Okay.
Yeah.
And it's located where?
On 7th and Cedar. And you know, I always struggle with Second Samoan because it has that exclusivity connotation to it. If you're not Samoan, you're not part of it. But that's so that, you know, so that way we can know who we are, right? Sort of like for identification purposes. Mm-hmm. But it's a Christian church. Mm-hmm. And that's where I've been the last 25 years.
25 years. So yeah. You came up with the name? I mean, God told you? He went to school. Was it called this before? And then you moved in?
Yep. It was called Second Samoan. It started in 1976. And I became the pastor in 1994.
Wow. So, congratulations. Yeah.
Thank you.
So you've been pastoring. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, let me ask you this. What made you step out of faith to run for city council district 1? Tell us about that.
Well, I've been trying to help a lot of people on that corner of 7th and Cedar. And okay. I had a circuitous way of getting into the ministry. My dad was a pastor. My grandfather on my mother's side were pastors.
Wow.
So I never wanted to become a pastor.
But so, it was a generation thing, though.
Yes, but
so basically you was preacher boy.
I was a PK, preacher's kid.
We go preacher boy, that's a preacher yeah. boy. You know, that means yeah. he did nothing
yeah.
but pray. So your whole generation is in the Christ. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
So you didn't want to be a preacher.
I didn't want to become a preacher. And then my dad passed in 94, mm-hmm. and the community then rallied around, and because I was a lay leader.
Right. What is that?
It's a lay leader is someone who's doing Sunday school and teaching Bible study mm-hmm. and that sort of thing. So I was doing that for my dad's church when he passed. And so the community came around and said, well, you're it. And
you said, no, I'm not.
Well, I struggled with it. And for 3 years, I did the ministry part-time. And then I started going to the seminary. I went to Claremont School of Theology. Mm-hmm. in Claremont, and then our denomination ordained me in 2001.
Okay.
And I've been there ever since, so.
Now, are you happy you made that decision?
Yes, and my wife is in the audience, she can attest
What's
to that.
What's your wife's name?
Marita.
Marita, hi! Thanks for bringing the t-shirt. Thank you, she brought the t-shirt. Okay, yeah. So this time you become a pastor, okay, which you didn't wanna be a pastor.
I struggled with it.
Okay, so basically, would you like Daniel in the lion's den? Did you? Did you run Jeremiah? You know Jeremiah ran away.
He sure did.
And he did not want to preach. Yeah. The people that God uses don't want to do it. Moses.
Absolutely.
He said, don't use me. I've studied.
Absolutely.
Right?
And Gideon was also a big
running
from God
person.
Well,
Gideon thought he was so small. You see, that's our problem. We think God used the least of us. You know, Gideon was so small and he couldn't believe that God would use such a man to get an army together. And the army that God chose was regular men. They wasn't fighters, you know. So Gideon, wow.
Yeah. So I was reluctant, and I just, after going to seminary, I realized, you know, this is my track. God has something bigger for me than just climbing the corporate ladder.
Okay.
So I've been there for 25 years, and I've paid attention to what the community needs are, and, you know, that's why I'm running for city council.
Okay, because you was a pastor, and you said, no, we need help. Okay, so the first question I got, how are you planning to serve Long Beach? How you serving us?
Yeah.
You want to be councilman? What are you going to do?
Yeah. So I guess one of the challenges with that question is that it presupposes that I'm the only person that does the work, right?
Yes.
It presupposes that.
Well, that's why we're voting for you.
Yeah, but
to see,
but to see how that's problematic, right, T. Lily?
Yes,
because
that's problem.
There's a presupposition that one person will make a difference. Well, I do make a difference. Mm-hmm. But part of the difference that I make is I would come along and engage other folks in the community for this work of bringing our district out of the funk that it's in, right? Mm-hmm. So I'll be a catalyst. I'll come along with my core competencies and help people along the way, but part of the magic is in the district. Mm-hmm. I'm thinking about leaders like yourself.
Oh, isn't that sweet? You call me a leader. Praise the Lord.
Yeah. and if I hadn't walked the neighborhood and run into you,
that's right.
I would never have discovered the talent that you are.
Thank you.
And part of what I like to create is create the space where folks like you are able to have a voice. And that's what this campaign is all about.
Okay.
It's not necessarily just
it's
about
not about
me.
You. That's what it's you're telling me. It's not about me, okay?
Yeah.
Let me, question two. What do you think about the homeless situation and what do you feel you can, what can be done about it? Okay, we have so many homeless people in Long Beach.
Yeah.
And I was told, well, watching the news, they said they're coming from LA, they're coming from Hollywood. Every time I see them, I praise the Lord I'm not one of them. Because thank God I have a roof over my head. Rent is too high. We got a question with that one. What can we do about this homeless?
Yeah.
Tell us.
So, as a church pastor, we've been doing what we can, right? We provide, every 2 weeks, we provide a meal and some change for them.
Is that right?
Yeah.
You supply and meal and money.
Right.
And how much you talking about?
Big money. we're talking about big money here. Relatively, right?
Not saying I'm coming to your church to get the dollar or whatever, but I like to know where's your church located?
So that's another. That's a great question. But that question also presupposes certain things, right?
Mm-hmm.
It presupposes that the homeless are folks that we need to help.
Yes.
When in essence they have the solution to their problem.
Right.
That question presupposes that someone has a magic pill, a magic bullet to solve this problem. But you know, we've been dealing with homeless for years as a church pastor, as a local leader, and I think if we just provide a place where they can feel safe, right, and we have all these churches that are compassionate to the poor, pull our resources together and begin to make some long-term changes with their lives. I think that's where we can begin. And that's what my candidacy is about, right? I don't have all the answers, but I think together as a district, when we come together and then use municipal resources, we can begin to solve that problem. On a local level, we're taking people off the street through our transition transitional homes. And from there, we matriculate them into the pilot program, Section 8, and then eventually get them jobs so they can pay the market rate for the rents. So it's a very complicated process.
It's very complicated.
Yeah.
It's very complicated. And you need, like myself, I need people who take it seriously. Mm. Actions speak louder than words. Yeah. Right? So you could talk all this yang yang until your nose bleed. I need to see what you're doing. I need to see it. Actions speak louder than words. And we have so many people that have to talk, but I don't see the walk, you see. And being the pastor of a church, that's a hard job by itself. That's a very hard job. We need to pray for our pastors more because we don't really think you guys go through anything. I mean, you know, you're a pastor of the church. What problems do you have? But believe it or not, the devil attack pastors
probably
more than anybody,
so,
because your job is to close the church, stop feeding the homeless, stop giving away money. You know, the devil wants us to stop. But don't do that. Don't give up. And I think you are an awesome man of God. And to be a pastor, now you want to become city council, District 1. Isn't that more work on you besides being a pastor? So are you putting too much on you? Are you letting God lead you? Tell us about that.
Yeah, it's definitely more work. Right, but with that also, it's more resources. It's more connection with people, right? It's like having a bigger pulpit, if you will.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Where I'm not just confined to the Samoan community, but I'll expand it to include everybody else. And also budget-wise, I mean, Long Beach has a $4 billion budget, $500 million discretionary, and that's a lot of resources.
Yeah. And they have it.
They have it. Yeah.
Okay. The thing is, we need to go get it. I notice a lot of people, I go out and I said, well, you could go down there and get this and get food stamps. And they don't want to. It's like we want things handed to us. Here you go. Yeah. It don't work like that, baby.
Yeah.
God bless a doer. Right? If you're a doer, you will get blessed. But a lot of people, the devil, I'm going to call it the devil. You call it bipolar. And, mental is still the devil. It's spirits. The demon-possessed man said to Jesus, my name is Legion, which is many. That's what he said to Jesus. And I went around asking pastors, how much is many? Because I couldn't really understand that scripture. We are many. How much is many? Usually God tells us in the word of God that he had 10,000 men, not including women and kids, correct? Mm. But the possessed man said we are legions, which means many. So a lot of people are mentally disturbed by the devil. That's literally, I'm just saying my opinion, okay? Yeah. Because we say a lot of them, I believe that they closed a mental institution a couple of years ago, I was told, and they just let them out. You know, we ain't helping you no more. We don't have the finances, just fly like a bird. And to tell you a quick testimony about myself, I was at Top Value on Pacific, 1:30 in the afternoon in Long Beach. I stepped out my car, and all of a sudden, this demon man was in front of my face. And he said, I should cut your throat. I hate women. Mm. And I looked at him, and I just started screaming Jesus' name. It's 1:30 in the afternoon. The sun is shining. And this possessed man is in my face at Top Value right there on 6th and Pacific.
Right.
I got back in my car, closed the door, and he walked away. And I went in Top Value and I told the manager, God, why did I do that? Mm. They didn't close the whole store down and everybody went outside and looking for this man. I didn't know what he looked like. He was an African American. But my whole thing is when that happened, he didn't know me. I didn't know him. But you could tell he was possessed by the devil. And I happened to be the woman or the servant of God that he chose to hurt, you see. And I pulled up blasting gospel. So we hear this on the news every day. Every day you hear someone got run over. You see the young boy, he was what,
14
years old?
Or, yeah.
The other day, last Monday, he was run over and he died. Going to school, 8 o'clock in the morning. You hear about women. walking for lunch break and a demon comes out of a building and just beat her up. So we have to be prepared. You have to be prayed up at all times. Okay? Yeah. So getting back to you, we was talking about homelessness, and I noticed a lot of them have mental.
Yeah.
It's about mental. It's about demons. Yeah. See, and people don't take demons seriously. They really walking around this earth. That's why God told us in Ephesians chapter 6. Put on the whole armor of God. Amen?
Yeah.
The whole armor of God.
Yeah.
Because we don't know what's going to happen to us from one minute to the next. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So what you're saying is you need the help of people. You can't do this by yourself.
No, I can't do it.
When did you realize that you can't do this by yourself? Did you get sick? Because sometimes stress makes you sick. Yeah. You know that, right?
My wife tells me all the time that I can't do it by myself. So.
All the time.
Yeah.
She says, and you can't do it by yourself. Yeah. What do you think, he's Superman or what? Yes?
And whenever she tells me that, I want to do it by myself, right? It's one of those, it's a man thing. But interesting how your cut is for that story in the Bible, Legion, right?
Mm-hmm.
Many.
Many.
Right?
How many is many? Yeah.
Well, I don't know.
Bam!
But
I'm asking the pastor, how much is many?
But I was going to offer my cut on it.
Okay.
Right? So
bring it.
So there's chaos and then there's order. There's chaos and then there's order. So chaotic is many, right? And order is one, right? So there's always that tension between many and one, many and one. Many and one. And we see that in contemporary 21st century American society. And part of what we have done is we've medicated, we've come up with scientific medication to medicate the many so they're orderly, right? Mm-hmm. But there's always that tension between many. If you have too many, you go chaotic. If you have too much order, you ossified. So I think something in the middle would be good for everybody.
And what's the middle?
Well, and that's the Christ event. That's the Christ person. That's the person of Christ. That's where Jesus exists.
Okay.
He existed between God, his Father, which is orderly, right, and legion, which is many. Mm-hmm. And he embodied this physical manifestation of divinity, right, that's subject to limitations and all that stuff. And he lived well in the world, and he set a really good example for us Christians to follow. So
let me ask you, getting off to talking about you, being a pastor, what do you do when people disappoint you? What do you do when you think God is leading you one direction and it makes a U-turn? What do you do? Tell us, how do you deal with situations like this?
Well, if you're just asking about the behavior, right? There's a certain biological stuff that goes on in your body when people disappoint. But I think a much more relevant question is, who do you be? What is the being that you are when someone disappoints you?
Okay.
And for me, you know, and I struggle with this, for me it's real peace. I want to be that person which is peaceful when people disappoint me or folks disappoint me. And I know that's a good question, but
Thank you.
What I work
I just
on.
Made it
I work on my
it's
on
not
my
on
being.
The list.
Yeah.
I just wanted to know because I go through that.
Yeah, and I try to keep a sense of humor, too, because it's important.
Sense of humor. And you know, peace comes from God. Mm. So I give you peace, real peace, for those far and near. But evil people is like the raging sea. Waves toss up mud and waste. For there is no peace for evil people, says the Lord. Mm. I read the Bible.
Yes, you do.
I read it. Yeah. I'm constantly reading it.
Yeah.
Okay, the last question. Is there anything that you want us to know, okay, for people to vote for you? Like right now, we got November 5th. Please vote. This is important. You have mine, okay? I don't know
Thank
about
you.
Anyone else, but I will, you know, vote for you. You want somebody else vote. What you gonna say?
Well, go to my website.
Go to your website, which is what?
Missy4lb.com.
Okay. Missy Ford, F-O-R-D?
No, Missy, the number four.
Oh, number four, okay.
Yeah, lb.com.
Okay.
And it's got all of our pieces that we've sent out. It's got my platform. It's got the district map to be sure that you live in the district.
Okay.
And then if you want to volunteer for the campaign, you can do that as well. And more important, if you want to donate to the campaign, right? Mm-hmm. You can do that as well on our website. Missy4lb.com.
Do you hear it? Say it again.
Missy, M-I-S-I, the number four, lb.com.
Now, I wanted to let everybody know, he had a new rally, and I happened to walk past, and DeAndre was there.
Yeah.
And DeAndre said, hi, T. Lily. And I said, oh, my God, you remember me? And he said, really? Are you seriously asking me, do I remember you? And he said, I'm voting for him.
Yeah.
I need you to support him.
Yeah. So DeAndrews is one of our strong supporters.
Yes, yeah. Yes. And he's at out of town because he was supposed to be here.
Yeah.
Who else is supporting you?
I have pastor friends, right? They don't live in the district, but they've lent their support.
Okay.
I have strong support in the Latino community.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Pastors in the Latino community who support me. I speak a little bit of Spanish, right?
Is that right?
Yeah. I went to Mexico for a couple of weeks and lived with a family there, so I know a little bit Spanish.
Was your wife with you?
No, I didn't take her with me. She stayed home.
Okay. How long have you been married?
28 years.
28 years.
Yep. Yep. I have a profound relationship with my wife, you know, and
profound.
That's
profound. What does that mean?
Well, it just is, right? I mean, we've been together for a long time, and I respect her, and she respects me, and we've been doing ministry together for 25 years.
That's
so
wonderful.
Yeah, we have three kids.
You have three kids. Yeah. What's the ages?
26, 25, and 17.
Wow, and your grandparents, yeah.
Not yet, we're working on
wow,
it.
Wow, that's wonderful.
Well, I don't know if we're working on it, but they're working on it.
I don't think you
my
have
son
any.
And his wife are working on it.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
So. What else I want to ask you? First of all, I'm so excited that you're on my show. Thank you so much for my T-shirt. My sister made mine's Love Bachelor. She's at the house watching the T-Lily show. Thank you. I just also wanted to say to my audience and all your family members, tell me about your people here. Who is this? This gentleman here booked you for a photo.
Yep.
I'm kind of upset with him because you got to get out of here.
I have to go. Lambert Aduki.
Lambert what now?
Lambert Aduki.
Okay, we're going to move
Congo.
On with that.
Yeah.
Okay, that's Ralph's wife. And who's the gentleman next to you there? With the gray hair?
Yeah, Daryl.
Daryl Delgado.
Hi, Daryl. Yeah. And then that's your wife.
And that's my wife, Marietta.
And I'm Billy.
Hi, thank you for standing up. Yes, you can.
You asked a question about homeless.
Yes.
Yeah. I don't know if any, as you said, we've lived in the district for so many years. And I think one of the things that he's running is being accessible. And I don't know if any of the candidates, you know, experience someone knocking on your door at 9 o'clock at night, asking for a towel. Someone knocking at your door at 8 o'clock at night, you know, when we just got done with dinner and asking for food. Someone knocking on your door and asking for a blanket. You know, we've experienced that in so many years because we are right there in the community with the homeless. So when you talk about homeless, it's just not talk. You're there. And, you know, he's run, this is his third time. And this time, homeless issue and homeless problems has gone worse. In District 1 and in Long Beach.
Yes, it has.
So I haven't seen anything. And it's not an issue that's easy. It's a very complicated one because it involves housing, work, jobs, and mental health issues. So it's not one that we can fix, you know, that. So that is really an issue that it's really a hit home for me, because we're right there. And someone knocking and asking for a ride to a homeless shelter, and who gets up, he goes and take them. Mm-hmm. So we want to do something. We want to help, and we want to change that. And I think this campaign is about. It's not about us. It's about the whole community. So thank you for having us on this show.
Oh, you're so welcome. I'm such a baby. I cry a lot. I cry. I do, because I'm just so grateful to God that I have a roof over my head. Okay, and I lay in my bed and go, thank you, Lord. Especially when it's cold. I've been there. Okay, years ago, 20 years ago, I was in a women's shelter and stuff. So I've been there, and okay, the thing is, rent is too high. That's the problem. The rent is so high, we don't get that much money, and you ask them for triple of the little income that we receive.
Yeah.
Like, we don't have the, we have Section 8, low income. What's the problem? Why is the rent is so high?
So we need to stabilize rents, right?
And how do we do that?
Well, we put in policy. We codify it. We put a cap on how much the landlords could increase every year. AB 1482 recently passed, so the governor will sign that, and that basically puts a cap of 5% annually on rents throughout the whole state.
Okay.
And when they do that, all the cities have to comply, and the counties.
And when's this going to start?
I'm not sure. I think it's October 1st.
Because we right. voted. I thought we won for low income. That's what I was told, that yeah. we won. They're just supposed to be lowering in the rent. Well, I know you got to go.
Yeah.
I know you got to go. We got a wonderful singer. My God, I got to interview him. Wait till you find out how I met him. I want to say thank you so much for being on my show. Please support Missy. Please support him. Let's give him a chance. This is his third year. Yeah. And the good news is he's on the T. Lily Show. That's the good
right.
news.
Ah. I'm blessed.
You have to leave. I know he keep looking at his watch telling me, you know, we got to get out of here. So I'm going to close with you saying thank you. Don't give up.
Yes.
November 5th, please don't. And if you don't win, God, Lord knows, if you win, we go party in that alley. I tell you, we go party. Because I have a sign in my window, and I also have your sign in my yard. And I noticed you have a lot of your signs around Main Avenue. Two homes in front of me have your signs in the window and stuff. But if you don't win, just like me, T. Lily was nominated for Best Television Show again. And I don't let it stop me. If I don't win, I keep moving on. So I just want to say that to you. We need you.
Yes.
And if it's not this year, it might be next year. So you want to close your interview with something?
Thank you so much for having me, T. Lily. It's a pleasure being here. And thank you for being open, being my neighbor.
Oh, yeah.
And God bless you.
Well, thank God I still can pay rent. Amen. Because if I can't pay rent, I'm going to be at your door.
Yeah.
You said we can knock. Thanks for the pizza. I was at your house. They brought me pizza, did I tell you?
Oh, they did.
We had a bunch of pizza.
Oh.
And your wife said, you want a slice? Yeah. Do you remember that day you brought me pizza? Thank you so much for being on the T. Lily Show. November 5th, we go vote. First district, City Council in Long Beach. And this is it. Go on his website. Tell us how to get on your website again.
Missy4LB.com.
Missy4LB.com.
Yes.
And your mother and father named you Missy. Did you ever ask them why?
Why did they call me Missy?
Yeah.
Well, Missy is Missy Poena, short for Missy Poena.
Okay.
But they named me after a missionary that came down and taught at the seminary.
Is that right?
In Samoa, yeah.
And they fell in love with his name?
They fell in love with his name.
Now, you have any brothers and sisters?
I have one brother and three sisters.
And they located where?
Arizona, Lakewood, Samoa.
Well, we can't use their votes. No. We can't lie with that one, right? We need to show it.
No, they have to live here.
So why don't they live in Long Beach?
They used to live in Long Beach, and then
the rent was too high.
Well, they grew out of Long Beach. They overgrew Long Beach. Okay. Outgrew
Long Beach. But thank you so much for being on the T Lily Show. See you in a minute with my next guest. God love you, and so do I. Peace.
God is good.
All the time.
The name of the song is called How Great Thou Art.
Yes. All right. Amen.
Oh, Lord, my God, when I'm in awesome wonder, consider all the world thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul,
proclaim,
my God, how great thou art. Yes. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. How great thou art.
I have an awesome, anointed singer. He sings gospel, he sings old school, he's just anointed. Please welcome Donkey Man to the T. Lily Show. All right! Yeah. Welcome to the T. Lily Show. First of all, I thank God I met you. I needed help with my groceries, and that's how we met. And you came and you said, I'm an entertainer, and boom! Then I asked you to please perform on my birthday party, which was September 15th at Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles Lounge, okay? Matter of fact, our next show at Roscoe's Chicken and Waffle Lounge is going to be October 20th. There's a mystery little play, and we dance, we lip sync, karaoke. Oh, man, it's awesome. We dance, for sure. Then my next big show is Halloween. Yes, Halloween night, I'll be at Roscoe's Chicken and Waffle Lounge, my first comedy show there from 7 to 10. 7:30 East Broadway in Long Beach, California. It's Halloween. They're going to give away prizes for best costume. So please show up. 7 to 10. You can't beat it. Please welcome Donkey Man back to the show. Yes! You know, first of all, I am so excited to have you on my show.
It's a pleasure to be here.
I'm going to ask you this. How long have you been singing?
About 30 years.
30 years.
Yeah, or more.
30 years. So are you in a group, or are you solo, or you whatever?
Solo.
You solo?
Solo, yeah.
Okay, do you write your own songs?
Most of them.
You do? Mm. And what is your songs about? Love?
Most of
Everybody
them.
Everybody writes songs about love.
Yeah, I got love songs, I got humorous songs,
Okay. You
know, and some of them are like things that happen, like stories.
What about gospel?
Gospel as well.
Okay. Yeah. When I asked you to be on my show and you said you would love to, I was really excited about it because I wasn't expecting you to say yes so quickly. I was just like, well, I'm booked then, because when I had my show September 15th, you had another booking that night and you still made it, and I want to thank you for that.
You're welcome.
You opened my show singing How Great Thou Art. Excellent song, beautiful voice. What made you pick that one?
Well, that song is a song that tells about the greatness of God. So what better song could you choose, you know?
But and that
it, you know, I always say that your first, your first thought mm-hmm. is the right thought.
The right thought.
You know, and when that song came to my mind, I said, that's it.
Because you asked me. Mm-hmm. What song? I said, yeah. I don't know. It's your thing. Mm-hmm. Should I bring my guitar? Should I bring the piano? So mm-hmm. I'm so glad God told you what to do.
Yeah, and you know God is so good, and you know He made us connect.
Yes.
You know.
Yes. So He's well, I can carry my groceries, so that's the only thing I got. And you was the only human on the street.
Yeah.
It was what 11 o'clock in the morning or 12 mm-hmm. in the afternoon, and. I looked at you and said, oh, God, I need some help. I can't carry these bags. And God said, ask them. And I asked you, and thank you. Mm-hmm. It all started with groceries. That's how it all started. Tell us where you perform at. When is your next show besides T. Lily's?
I have a show in L.A.
Okay.
At 48 and Hoover.
When is this?
November, 19th?
November 19th, okay. Yeah. So you still have me, October, right?
Yeah.
Okay, October 20th.
Mm-hmm.
And I might want you to come and blow a tune for Halloween if you're available.
Okay.
Okay, because I need to change in my costume. I can't do both.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I let your wife know. How's that? Sure. I think women, we would keep you posted. Mm-hmm. We had Missy. Have you ever heard of him? He's our neighbor, you know that.
Oh, yes, I heard of him. I saw his posters.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right near your house.
Yeah, but the first time I saw him.
Right.
You know.
Right. He's running for District 1. Have the slightest idea. Yeah. I don't know anything about our district, but I know we live there. How long have you been living in Long Beach?
About 2 years.
2 years? Mm-hmm. Only 2 years? My God. What do you think of us?
I love Long Beach.
I love Long Beach. LB! Yeah. It's the best.
Yeah. Sometimes I forget that I'm living in Long Beach and all the things that is there that we could do.
Right, but you're from Belize. You and your wife are from Belize.
Yes, Central America.
Wow. When the last time you've been there?
About 20 years ago.
20 years ago. You still have family there?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, is your mother and father still here?
My mother and father is deceased already. Okay. But I have sisters, I have brothers.
Okay, and your wife is from Belize?
Yes.
I was told that you guys knew each other in grammar school.
Yeah.
And she happened to just go to one of your concerts in L.A.
We connected and we've been out of touch for a while.
Mm-hmm.
And then we connected on social media. We found each other.
Oh, Facebook.
Yeah.
All right. That's
first
wonderful.
On one of the older ones. One of the older ones that they had before. What was it? High five.
Yeah. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how she found you, or you found her?
I found her. I was searching.
You were searching for her?
Yeah.
Oh, so you was looking for her?
Yeah, I typed her name in, and then it popped up. I said, well, there you go.
What made you think of her?
Well, from school, I used to have
But it was grammar school.
Yeah, I had an eye for her from then.
From grammar school?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah. I always thought that she was my soulmate.
She is.
Mm-hmm.
She is. Isn't that sweet? I wonder where's my soulmate.
Well, he's somewhere.
He said my soulmate
sometimes,
is somewhere.
Sometimes we never find him.
No, well, I think my only soulmate right now is Jesus. Amen. I can't do that. You have any music? Tell us how do we look you up? What do we do? I want to go home and listen to you.
You could go to YouTube.
Okay.
There's a lot of videos there.
And YouTube and look up what?
If you
Donkey
type
Man?
D-A-N-K-I. Donkey.
D-U.
D-A.
I'm sorry. D-A.
N.
K-I. K-I. Donkey Man. Okay, so I go to YouTube.
Yes.
Listen to what he's saying.
Once you type that in, a whole bunch of videos is going to pop up.
And it's you.
It's me.
They're all you.
All day.
Okay, so go to YouTube. Come on, go to YouTube. Look up D-A-N-K-I Man. And bam! And always remember, I see them on the T. Lily show. Yes. He's going to close my show with a wonderful song. What's the name of the song?
Fill My Cup, Lord.
Now, where's the song? I love that song.
Yeah.
Fill My Cup, Lord.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, we're going to be at Golgotha Trinity Baptist Church.
Yeah.
October 19th.
Okay.
Okay, I gave him your name and number.
All right.
So
we'll be there.
So I'm telling your wife, we have a
yes,
book in there. Then also
there.
The 20th is the Senior Sunday Spectacular, October 20th from 3 to 6 at Roscoe's Chicken and Waffle Lounge. Then on the 31st, T. Lily's going to be doing her first comedy show there. Please come out and support me. You're going to die laughing. We got to go. He's going to close my show. I want to thank Mama Sean Kitchen for coming out. It was the good spaghetti.
Oh, the best.
We had spaghetti and salad and garlic bread. And oh, my God, it was delicious. I want to thank Mama Sean Kitchen, also you and your wife, Missy. Let's get his name together. Tagaloa. How did he say it? It's Tagaloa. Am I saying that right?
Yes, you're okay, right on the money. Thank Missy you. Tagaloa.
Missy Tagaloa, and especially God for blessing me and Pagnet. Especially thank you for watching the Tea Lily Show. I love you. I love you, and so do I. Till next week. I know it's over, baby. I can't help it. See you. Peace out. How was it, guys?
This song is called Fill My Cup, Lord. It's a happy song. And as long as you have Jesus in your life, your cup will be always full.
Yes, yes, yes.
Fill my cup, Lord. And lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up and make me whole. Like a woman at the well, I was seeking for things that could not satisfy. And then I heard my Savior saying, draw from that well that never shall run dry.
Yeah.
Fill my cup, Lord, and lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup, I fill it up and make me whole. So my brother, if the things this world gave you leave hunger that not pass away, my blessed Lord will come and save you. If you kneel to him and humbly pray, fill my cup, Lord, and lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up, and make me whole. Let's sing it together now. Okay. Fill my cup, Lord, and lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup, I fill it up and make me whole. Fill my cup, I fill it up and make me whole. Fill it up.
It's a Jesus thing.